This is the ultrasonic sensor that we use for Arduino. This is one of the most famous component that is used for measuring the distance, and it's being used in cars to avoid obstacle. It's being used in robotic arm. These are two speaker type modules. So this is a transmitter that acts as a speaker, and it transmits ultrasonic. Ultrasonic means this is above the hearing frequency of human, which is above 25 kilohertz. So this will be around 40 kilohertz. So this transmits, and this piece acts like a receiver. They put R here and it receives it. Here is how it operates. I've drawn this diagram to illustrate it. This is the ultrasonic sensor, and this is a transmitter, usually shown with TX. This sends ultrasonic wave, and when it goes and hits, for example, this object, this is a wall, it hits and returns or bounces back. The signal that travels from here to the wall and coming back will take some time. And the phase of the signal at this point is compared with the phase at this point, and we will see what is the delay. And by calculating the delay of the phase, because we know the speed of sound, we can determine the distance. So with Arduino, we can get the distance of the object from this device from this point. And in one of the application would be that you may build a smart car and install this at the front of the smart car and program your Arduino that whenever this approaches to an object, for example, when it reaches 30 centimeter, you can stop the car. Or when it reaches a certain distance, you can use the steering and turn the car left or right to another direction until it finds a clear path and then proceeds. So this can be used in so many ways. The module has four pins. This is a VCC, will be connected to 5 volts. This is ground, and then we have TREG and ECHO. And the chips that are used here with conjunction to the calculation from Arduino, the proper wave signal is sent here, and the wave phase is measured, and when it receives the signal, compares it, and from the delay, it calculates, and the value will be available within the Arduino. Here is a wiring diagram, and I've used FirstThing. This is a free software from firstthing.org. You can draw the schematic and wiring. And this is the ultrasonic sensor from left. This is VCC. This has been connected to 5 volts. To the right, we have ground, have been connected to the ground of Arduino. And then the TREG is connected to pin 12, and ECHO is connected to pin 11. In order to use this module, you need extra set of codes that have been written specifically for this device to work, and it's called library. So we are going to download the library plus some code that is within the Arduino IDE. Together, they will do the calculation for us. So let's first get the library, and then I'm going to explain the code for this. First, let's go to this address that I will provide you, turbojax.com, and you will see this page and download the library. This is the official library that is there, but this is a direct link. Click and then save it somewhere, let's say in downloads. Then go to sketch, include library, and click add zip library. From here, point it to your downloads, and that is ultrasonic library. Once you click and open, it will be included in your library. Click on File, Examples, and scroll down until you see New Ping, and from here, Ping Example. Include newping.h is part of the library that you just downloaded and installed. We're using the define as a constant. We are setting a constant. This is a text trig pin, trigger pin, and here is pin 12, and then echo pin, which is pin 11. And then the maximum distance, this is in centimeters, 200 centimeters, because this device cannot read more than that, you will get error. But you can play with this and reduce it for more precision. And after that, we are using this class. This is a class name, the same name, and then sonar. And you can put different name if you wish. But after that, this needs three arguments, the three arguments that have been defined here in order. So first the trig pin, then echo pin, and then max distance pin. If you do not define this, this you also you can put here, for example, that 12 and echo pin 11, and you can put 200 as an integer. After that, we go to the setup and serial begin. I've said change it to 9600 baud for the serial monitor to display the text for us. And here inside the loop, we just wait 50 milliseconds. After that, it prints this ping. And then this is the one that is giving us the value, sonar.ping_cm. This is in centimeter. So this is actual value, and then print ln. So this prints this text. And then this prints, after that it prints this, and after the value we print cm centimeter and ln. This means new line. So after that there will be an enter. It goes to the next line and loops and prints all these three portion on the screen, and the loop continues like that. Here I have connected yellow, the last pin, to 5 volts, this brown to ground, and then the trig, the orange, is connected to pin 12, and then echo is connected to pin 11. Let me just upload the code, and as you can see, it continuously shows when it's far beyond, but if I put my hand, you will see that it shows 5 centimeters or 6 centimeters, and then the distance increases. And it is directional. Put the phone here at 10 centimeter. And flatten it, and as you can see, it shows 10. Let me go to 20. It shows 20 centimeter. And as I move, continuously it displays the value. Now I'm putting it on a surface. And 3, 4, 5 centimeters. Here, this is the value, and you can do some action based on this. Let's say you're building a smart car and you want to stop the car, the motor, or turn off the motor when the distance to the object reaches, let's say, 8 centimeter or 10 centimeter. So you can say like this, if this is a distance, if distance is smaller than 8 centimeters, so this is a condition, the distance is smaller than 8 centimeters from here to here. This is the action. You can say digital write, and your motor is connected, let's say, to pin 5, and low mean turn off. It will be turned off, or maybe the light will be turned on, or something else. So based on the distance, you can take some action. Let's have a look at the other example here. If I go to the ping, and here is a three sensor. And if you are using multiple sensors, remember from our previous code, this is the trig pin, the second one is the echo pin. So this is the trig pin, and this is the echo pin. You can put multiple one. And this is a trig pin for the second sensor, and this is for the third one. These are the maximum distance. So this way you can use three sonars, and this will go continuously, read the value, and this eye is referring to each sensor. To read sonar number one, you will just type 0, that is referring to sonar number one, that is distance in centimeter for you. And if you want number two, just put it 1, and if you want sonar number three, put 2. And you can have more sensors for a smart car. If you need 4, 5, 6, or even 10, you can do that.